Hi, my name is Craig Bowers. I'm the department chair here at Ivy Tech Community College in Lafayette, Indiana, over the agriculture and precision agriculture equipment technology programs. We're out here today, just got done flying on some seed for this native prairie grass planting that we're trying to make this mound area into. We were fortunate to be able to secure funding from the Wabash River Enhancement Corporation to be able to purchase the seed to be able to do this. Got a lot of different help along the way from John Scott and Purdue Extension using the UAV to broadcast the seed. From Jared taking the video here as well, helping us in that process too. But also Brianne Lowe, Indiana State Biologist with Natural Resource Conservation Service, gave us a lot of advice and guidance along the way about how to approach this as well. Our long-term goal here is after a few years when it's established well to use it as an educational tool and reach out to local elementary schools, junior high students and teachers, and hopefully bring some of them out here just to give them a little bit of an educational experience as well.
Hello, my name is Don Haberlin. I work here at Ivy Tech. I wear two hats. I'm hired on as an adjunct, teach a couple different classes, and I'm also what's called the farm operator. We have a full-time staff that's the farm manager who pretty much plans and what's going on, and then I help run and assist. They say this is the best time of the year to put seed out on the ground, even though it's frozen and the snow's here. What we're putting it on with the drone. The mound itself was created when they built the school. They had to dig the retention pond area for the construction site, and this was the spoils left over. And it's just kind of been sitting here for 10, 12 years, collecting weeds and growing stuff. So we put a lot of work into cleaning it off and getting it ready. And we decided the best way to put the seed on there was with a drone. Traditional equipment, you could drill that, but the mound really doesn't lend itself to that. So the backup might have been to hand applicate with one of those spreaders. We decided this drone could do just as good a job, and we can build in our technology. And we got John Scott here doing that, and it's working out pretty well so far. We'll see how it goes out when we get done today.
I'm John Scott, the Digital Ag Extension Coordinator with Purdue Extension and also on the Wabash Heartland Innovation Network Initiative. I'm the liaison between those, and we're taking this DJI Agris. It's got a spreader attachment on the bottom, and we are applying a native prairie mix, pollinator mix, to this mound you see over here in the background. So it's a little over 3 acres, about 4 acre footprint that we are trying to apply frost seed this prairie grass into on this wonderful snowy day.
Got here is a mixture of two different seed mixes. When we got them, there was what they call a small or a fine mix and a coarse or larger mix, but both of them are still too small to be able to calibrate, so we've mixed in some pelletized lime to give us a filler. So probably the biggest headache today is making sure we keep this uniformly mixed when we put it in the drone, so it's spreading the right amount of each seed size.
So what we're looking at here, the red triangle arrow-shaped thing is the drone itself, and you can see it flying the job. The yellow lines is the job, so that's what it's going to fly as it goes. So right now we've done 0.1 acres so far. We're doing 3.6 feet per second. So in order to set this map up, I actually took this RC controller that we're looking at, and I went and I actually put the points in. So these purple points you see, I set those waypoints to create the boundary, and then it's flying the boundary now. As far as that, once I set the overlaps and stuff, so it's about a 16-foot swath, then it automatically laid all the yellow in for me. I didn't do that. It did all that for me. And then it'll just fly that job. It'll go down, it'll come back, it'll go down, it'll come back.
The reason we took so long here today is we had some complications as part of the issue. First and foremost, the initial complication we had was some shorts with the equipment itself. So we got that taken care of, so where we were able to get the thing open, to get the seed out. The next issues we really ran into was the seed flow. That real fluffy seed, we had mixed it with that pelletized lime, and we mixed all the seeds together, try to give it some carrier, try to give it a way to flow a little bit better. That stuff, there was so much chaff, it just still couldn't really go through. There is a little agitator in the bottom of this, but there's a separation probably about 4 or 5 inches, and it would just get too much much chaff in there, then it would block the flow again. And it kept throwing an error saying that my spread tank was empty, when in fact it was still pretty well full, but that bottom had filled up. So that caused some issues, where every time we'd have to land, clean it out, and a lot of times, sometimes just shake it and agitate it on the outside, we'd be able to get it done. But that added, every time we landed, that added to it. On top of that, every time you land, that hurts your efficiency with your battery life. Battery life on these devices is still critical. If you can't manage your battery life or do it well, you're gonna have issues. Luckily, we were able to go slow enough that we were able to keep up with our batteries till at the very end. The dispersal was great. Really, really pleased with what we saw up there as we walked through. Luckily, as you can see, I don't know, hopefully you can see in the distance, there's some snow here, right? So we were able to use the snow cover to kind of get an idea of what is our spread pattern. So we feel pretty confident that we have a good pattern. We have pretty good rate up there. We know from when we pre-measured everything and calibrated, what we have left over in seed and what we put on the hill, what we should have put on the hill, is pretty close to equal. So I'm really happy with that. With the flow, I can't promise that it's all in the right spot 100%, just with the dispersal. But as far as when it flowed well, it worked very, very well. We got a good pattern.